Hey all, it's Brian. If you've been building Angular apps for a while, like I have, you know the framework keeps evolving fast. Today, I'm going to show you how to modernize an older app step by step using the latest Angular features, modern host bindings and events, control flow, and signal inputs, so your code stays lean, future-proof, and ready for production. By the end of this video, your code will be smaller, a little faster, and overall more modern. And you'll see exactly how to quickly modernize several aspects of an existing application. A couple years back, I built this little Angular demo showing how to use the host binding decorator to bind an animation to a component host. Back then, it worked great, but Angular has come a long way. And now we have some much cleaner, more powerful ways to write this code. Let's look at the code that's making this happen. The app component is where this list of players lives currently. First off, this list is using the old ng4 structural directive. This isn't the way we want to do this anymore. Instead, we want to use a for block. This is part of Angular's modern built-in control flow syntax. It's a little cleaner, no more asterisk, no structural directive needed. This runs right inside Angular's new block syntax. And instead of track by, we now use track, and in this case, the player name. Same idea, just nicer to read. Because of that change, we no longer need the track by method over in the component TypeScript. We can just delete it. The for loop takes care of tracking for us. Let's switch back to the template now. There were a couple more things that we can improve. We've got two buttons here that use ngif, one for removing a player and one for adding. We can modernize these too, using if instead of the structural directive. Again, no more asterisk, no structural directive. This is the new syntax Angular recommends moving forward, and once you start using it, you won't want to go back. Okay, this is cool, but what does it have to do with host binding animations? Nothing, right? There aren't even any animations in this template. Well, this is because we're using host binding in the player component for this animation. So let's take a look. This is where the animations live. If you look here, we've got a host binding to run the animation. And then two host listeners, one for when the animation starts, and one for when it's done. But here's the thing, these decorators are still supported, but they're not the recommended way to bind things on the component host anymore. Now, we want to do this with the host property of the component. We'll switch this over in a minute, but first let's look at the animation itself. Here, we can see that we're using an external animation. Let's look at this real quick to better understand how it works. It's just a simple enter and leave animation. The enter alias allows us to animate an element when it is added to the DOM, and the leave alias does the opposite. It animates items as they leave the DOM. Okay, now that we know how this works, let's switch over to the host property. First, we add a new host property inside the component decorator, like this. That's it. Now the animation is bound to the component host. And since we're doing it this way now, we don't need this host binding anymore. Now we can move the start event to the host property too. We use parentheses for this just as we would for events in the template. Then we just need to call our start method. Now we can remove the host listener for this. And now we can do the same for the done event. We'll move it to the host, call the done method, then remove the host listener. We can also remove the import too since it's not needed anymore. Now, before we finish, there's one more modern pattern you'll definitely want to use here. Signal inputs. Right now, this uses the classic input decorator. But modern Angular gives us a newer way, using signal inputs, which makes the component more reactive. So we just need to switch this over to the new input function. Then we can remove the old decorator import. Now we're not done yet. Over in the template, we need to update it to use this signal input. What I'm actually going to do is create a template variable here with the let syntax, and I'm going to name it player var. Then I'll set this to the signal input. Then I just need to update all instances of the old player property. Using a template variable like this means we can reference player var directly without having to write player with parentheses every time. But since it's now a local variable, I do have to change the name. So pick your poison. All right, I think we've got everything. Let's save it and take a look in the browser. There we go. Add a player. Nice entrance animation. Remove a player. Smooth exit animation. And everything works exactly as it should. But now the code is more modern and ready for anything Angular throws at us in future updates. So that's it. A quick refactor of an older app using Angular modern syntax, new control flow, signal inputs, and cleaner host bindings. If you're building apps in Angular today, these patterns will help you write clearer, more reactive code, and they'll keep your apps easy to maintain long-term. If you enjoyed this video, hit that like button, and if you want more short-focused Angular tutorials like this one, go ahead and subscribe. I've got plenty more coming. Until next time, thanks for watching.